जहां उपस्थित हुए हैं, यही हम सब के आराध्य गौड़ीय वैष्णवों के हृदय संपद तथा परात्पर तत्व सच्चिदानंद विग्रह अनादि आदि सर्व कारण कारण गोविंद के
revered worshipable place for all the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, the place of Srimati Radhika's, Srimati Radhika's birthplace. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Parabrahma Paratattva, his eternal consort Srimati Radhika, she took birth here. There are several stories which give different information about how Srimati Radhika appeared. One story goes, when Nand Baba, he came to Gokul with all village people and all the Brajvasis. Then Vrishabhanu Maharaj also, he moved to this place. And this place is very near to the Jamuna River. So daily he would go to take bath in Jamuna River. One day when he went, then he saw that, of course, the Jamuna River was always full of so many lotus flowers. So he noticed that in one of the flowers, there was some effulgence coming out, and he was taken by surprise that how that light was coming. So he was attracted to that place, and he started moving towards that place, and he noticed that a young baby girl was playing in the flower, and her beauty, when he witnessed, he was startled, he was astonished to see. He never saw before like that, so he could not understand who she is. So he started looking in all directions, and when he saw that there was no one, so he quickly picked that baby girl in his lap and brought it to his home, and he gave that baby in the lap of Kirtika Devi. So that was Srimati Radhika. And in other scriptures it is also said that she was born of Vindhyachal, and Putna, she took Srimati Radhika, and when she was flying over this place, she dropped Srimati Radhika here. And in other scriptures, some of the stories is also there. So it is like different kalpas, different manifestation, different ways Srimati Radhika appears. Srimati Radhika is the eternal potency. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and his potency is Srimati Radhika. She is extremely merciful. And for Gaudiya Vaishnavas, we know that all the world, all the people, they believe that Krishna is the Supreme Person, is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But we understand that Srimati Radhika is even the cause of Krishna, and he derives all his power from Krishna. And she is so expert that she fully controls Krishna. There is no one else except Srimati Radhika who controls Krishna. Why she is able to control Krishna? The reason is because she is the only one who is capable to fulfill all the desires of Krishna. The moment Krishna desires something, Srimati Radhika fulfills those desires. Once when Krishna had appeared in Gokul, then Narad Muni, he came here and he took the darshan of Krishna, and then he was searching, oh, Krishna has taken birth, then must be his potency, his Radhani Shakti, Sarup Shakti, Srimati Radhika must have also appeared somewhere. So he started searching here and there. And then when he came to this place, he inquired from Vrishabhanu Maharaj, how many children do you have? He said, one, I have Shridam, one boy. He said, any daughters? He says, no. He didn't say no or yes. He was trying to hide, because if he says that he has one daughter, then quickly this news will spread all around. And then he was not sure that how long he'll be able to keep Srimati Radhika with him. So he didn't say anything, yes or no. But when Narad Muni insisted, then he found out, yes, Srimati Radhika was there. Then he insisted to take darshans, and Vrishabhanu Maharaj let him take darshans. When he brought Srimati Radhika in front of Narad Muni, the Narad Muni said, okay, that's good, the child is very good, now I must chant some mantras and do some mangalacharan. So he quickly go and bring few things, and he told him to bring some paraphernalia, like incense and etc. And when Vrishabhanu Maharaj went inside, then he quickly started doing so many prayers to Srimati Radhika, because he knew that she is the eternal potency, Haladni Shakti. And very soon she got pleased, and she gave him darshans in her Kishore Roop and with all the sakis. So Narad Muni got the blessings, and very soon when Vrishabhanu Maharaj came back, she again took the form of a baby child. And then Narad Muni started giving blessings to her. And then Vrishabhanu Maharaj, and then he took her back. So like that, she is very merciful. She is even more merciful than Krishna. And we know that as long as she is standing with Krishna, then Krishna is Rasraj. And when she is not with Krishna, then is Nirgun Brahma, Nishakti Brahma. So he derives his power from Srimati Radhika. And Prabhupada also told that in Braja there are so many gopis, unlimited gopis, and among all of them, 8 are prominent. And even in 8, 2 are prominent, Chandravali and Srimati Radhika. And out of 2, Srimati Radhika is even more superior. She is the best. Why? Because she controls Krishna, because she has all the potency to fulfill Krishna's all the desires. So today we are here by her causeless mercy and also by the mercy of our Gurudev and Vaishnavas. So we pray here with all our sincere desire that the goal, the supreme, the ultimate goal for which we are all striving and we are trying our best, with her all causeless mercy, she should give us the qualifications to serve them, the couple, the divine couple, in the moods which Sri Gurudev and our Acharyas, Sri Rupa Goswami and Srimad Mahaprabhu want to tell us and is giving us. We should be able to, we may be allowed to serve them in the same mood. And despite at this moment we are not qualified, but if she bestows her causeless mercy, then we can have all that qualification. Firstly, we can please our Gurudev and Vaishnavas, and then with their blessings and under their guidance, we can serve this eternal divine couple. Gaur Premanande Jai Jai Sri Radhe. This one announcement.